So there are generally two types of broadly categorized as the chemical, the you know, factors that stimulants or mutagens, that is, that affects, that creates mutation. As I've already told, that there are ionizing chemicals or ionizing radiations, and there are non-ionizing radiations. So non-ionizing radiations, there are UV among one of them. That is, UV light can create a major change in the DNA strands that they can bind together to form thymine dimers. And there are some non-chemicals are also there, which can create mutation in our genomic genetic structure. So there are different chemicals, actually. They are grouped, or they are divided into many types. That is, they can be base analogs. That is, like bromouracil, etc. They can imitate, or they have the structural homology with some of the base structures of DNA. That is, they can mimic actually the structure of any base, and like 5-bromouracil is structurally similar to thymine, and it can be incorporated in place of thymine. That is, in place, they can replace thymine, and that thymine generally that pairs with adenine. But in case of 5-bromouracil, it generally pairs more frequently with guanine. So in that case, we can very easily anticipate that there is a change of base pairing occurs due to this presence of base analogs. There are other base modifiers also that are the chemicals that make changes to a specific base, changing its ability to base pairing properly. That is, deamination of cytosine creates a uracil base that will pair with a adenine instead of guanine. And there are intercalating agents also, that is the chemicals that insert themselves inside the DNA helix and makes them very difficult for the other enzymes, that is the replication enzymes and the transcription factors, etc. They cannot reach, or they cannot read, or they cannot move through that DNA structure. That's why that change will be deleterious, because the fundamental processes can be hampered. So on the effect of gene mutation, on the effect of protein, based on that effect, mutation also can be divided into few types, which are very important. Number one will be silent mutation. Silent mutation is an interesting case of mutation. That is, there is a change in the codon, usually generally in the third position, that doesn't change the amino acid at all. That means we generally know with the knowledge of our genetic code that some codons are specifically code for some amino acids, but there are many amino acids that many codons generally codes for the same amino acid, because the number of amino acids is 20 and there are 64 of codons are there. So, you know, repetitive codons are there for one amino acid. So silent mutation generally an interesting one, because in this case, mutation do occur, but there is no, fundamental effect, because these two changed codons will code for the same amino acid. So ultimately, there will be no change in the amino acid makeup. So the mutation, though it had happened, but it will be silent, because there will be no phenotypic effect of that mutation in the genetic or the genotypic, there should be a genotypic change, but there should not be any phenotypic difference. So nonsense mutation is another mutation based on the effect on codon. So there is one silent mutation that doesn't actually affect something. But nonsense mutation generally refers to change a codon from amino acid specifically to a stop codon. We generally know there are three stop codons. So whenever a particular codon changes due to one base pair change, can lead to render them a stop codon. So then abruptly the amino acid sequence will be broken down, because there is a premature stoppage or premature signal to stop. So the amino acid that should be long enough, that is, that should not, should be maybe we can say that should be 20 amino acid long. So in between them, if there is a nonsense mutation, that is a normal codon which generally acts for an amino acid, generally becomes a stop codon now. So it will terminate, it will truncate the amino acid sequence, and the resulting amino acid chain will be shorter than the normal one. So this is a nonsense mutation, example of nonsense mutation. Again, there is a missense mutation. All these terminologies are very important. Change in a codon that changes the specificity to a different amino acid, that is changes the primary sequence of the polypeptide chain and alters the function of the protein, that is not making it the stop codon, that is stop codon is not coded there due to the mutation effect, but it will create, it will change a codon from another codon and it will create another amino acid rather than the normal one. So in this case of missense mutation, the sense will be different. That is the, if any polypeptide chain or any protein has this kind of amino acid, so that information will be changed by this missense mutation because there will be another new amino acid in that, in their genetic makeup or in their protein body or amino acid sequence, everything will be changed. And there are neutral mutation also because this change in the codon such, it happens in a such fashion or such manner that a different amino acid is specified. However, the new amino acid behaves similarly to the previous one or the original one. That is, has the similar functional group and does not generally alter the function of the protein. So in these two types, that is silent mutation or the neutral mutation, the changes occur, but the changed amino acid also has the same functional group with the normal one. So that's why ultimately there should not be much more related change in the amino acid or if the protein function is not hampered in a drastical way. So in case of silent mutation where there would be similar amino acid because the two change in the codon will make, will cause or will result in the same amino acid. And in the neutral mutation, the change do occur, but they are generally have the minimal effect on the protein because these two changed or the mutated amino acid will have the same functional group with the normal one. So these two cases will render the mutation less, you know, fatal, or missense or the nonsense mutation will can affect the, you know, cellular process in a much more profound way. So these are different. Another important type of mutation is frame shift mutation. This is, you know, we know that codons are generally triplet, that is three letter code, that is three bases generally makes up a codon. So we can say a very easy example like the man saw a fat dog or a fat cat. So you can say that in this sentence, all the words are of three letters, three alphabets are there. So if we can insert a different alphabet in between any of these three words, so the sense will be changed. So this similar, these things happen with the frame shift mutation because a shift of the reading frame caused by the deletion of one alphabet or deletion of one base or the insertion of a few of one or few nucleotides. So that create a numerous change at the totally the frame is shifted, the totally meaning will be changed. So you can very well guess that with that sentence example I have given, like the man saw a fat cat, the man saw the fat cat. So here if we just delete one single alphabet, that is the, so triplet codon will be formed. If you remove the T, then the codon will start from HE, from the T is removed. So HE will remain, but it will take another alphabet with it, the man. So it will take the M letter with it. So the first word will be HEM. So that, and now on from like this, the whole sentence, the meaning will be changed. So you can really guess that there will be no meaning at all. So a frame shift mutation when occurs, like a deletion or addition of an alphabet, an extra alphabet or deletion of a single nucleotide will create a havoc change, a profound change in the reading frame. So this is a very interesting one of the, this type of mutation, and it is called frame shift mutation. That is the total frame of the codon, that is the total information reading frame will be changed.